In this pathophysiology video, we will be learning about how the body regulates temperature. The human body maintains a constant temperature range of between 97 and 99 degrees Fahrenheit, with the average temperature of 98.6. Temperature regulation is accomplished by a part of the brain known as the hypothalamus. The hypothalamus responds to information from thermal receptors in the skin and organs. Let's take a closer look at how this works. Body temperature below 95 degrees Fahrenheit, 35 degrees Celsius, is called hypothermia. During hypothermia, thermal receptors send information to the hypothalamus to increase body temperature. The hypothalamus responds by increasing secretions of thyrotropin-releasing hormone, TRH. TRH then travels to the anterior pituitary gland and promotes the secretion of thyroid-stimulating hormone, TSH. TSH is carried by the blood to the thyroid gland, which responds by secreting the thyroid hormones T3 and T4, thyroxine. The thyroid hormones increase the body's metabolism, which helps to generate heat. Thyroxine affects the inner portion of the adrenal gland, called the medulla, by promoting the release of epinephrine, adrenaline. Epinephrine increases the body's metabolic rate, which generates heat and causes blood vessels to constrict. The hypothalamus also stimulates the sympathetic nervous system to increase muscle tone and shivering. Peripheral vasoconstriction helps to maintain heat in the core of the body. The cerebral cortex receives messages about the drop in body temperature and responds by influencing behaviors to conserve body heat, such as adding more clothing or seeking out a warmer environment. Hypothermia causes depression of the central nervous and respiratory systems, along with vasoconstriction, which can lead to ischemic tissue damage. During hypothermia, the Lewis phenomenon causes reperfusion of the extremities, which helps to keep these areas oxygenated. Hypothermia progresses from shivering to stupor and a decrease in cardiac output, acidosis, ventricular fibrillation, and death. An increase in body temperature is called hyperthermia. In early stages of hyperthermia, the hypothalamus works to decrease body temperature by inhibiting TRH secretion, which slows metabolism. Muscle tone and shivering decreases, and breathing may increase to help exchange body heat with the external environment. Sweat glands open and peripheral vasodilation of blood vessels helps to move heat away from the core to the extremities. Heat loss also occurs by way of transfer mechanisms, such as radiation, conduction, convection, and evaporation. Radiation is the transfer of heat from warmer to cooler areas, such as stepping into a cool building on a hot day. In conduction, heat is transferred from a warmer object to a cooler object. In convection, heat is carried away from the warmer body to the cooler surrounding air. An example would be using a fan. In evaporation, sweat carries heat away from the body. Infants may have problems with environmental temperature changes. Infants do not conserve or maintain heat as well as adults due to their small body surface area, lower levels of insulating adipose tissue, lower levels of sweat, inability to shiver, and a greater amount of vasoconstriction in cold environments. The elderly may also have problems with heat regulation due to a lower metabolism, slower blood circulation, decreased ability to sweat, and presence of chronic diseases. As hyperthermia progresses, nerves become damaged, cell proteins coagulate, and death can occur. Temperatures at or above 105.8 degrees Fahrenheit, 41 degrees centigrade, can cause convulsions. Some types of hyperthermia include heat exhaustion, which can cause profuse sweating and vasodilation, which can lead to dehydration, decreased blood pressure, and electrolyte abnormalities. Heat cramps, which are characterized by cramping of muscles from profuse sweating and sodium loss. Heat stroke, which occurs from prolonged stress on the thermoregulatory centers, which causes them to fail. Heat stroke can result in central nervous system degeneration, confusion, coma, and death. I hope you've learned something about temperature regulation, and we'll see you next time.